Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're actually going to be answering a question that was asked on Discord by Smoking Kipper, who's basically trying to get something like this top picture here, but is achieving something like this. And basically, he's wondering how to get this sort of shadow when there's nothing there. So we're going to be looking into that after the intro. Okay, so I've done a little bit of a mock-up here. It's similar, it's not exactly the same as what we had in the example. And you can see that I have this little option here. Now, obviously, what you could do, let me just make sure everything here is a group, so it's easier to understand. So we have a group here, and then if I was to take a plane and put it over top, that would be great. We'd get the shadow that we're looking for. However, what we don't get is the, and you can actually even make this longer if you wanted. So like, let's say you wanted to do like an interior render and you just want to see what's going on in here. You start to get the shadow that you're looking for, but you have this huge plane. So if I was to make this a group and I was to hide it, obviously you don't get that. If I was to apply a material, if I hit B here, and I'll just pick, let me just pick something like this. Maybe not. Maybe I'll just choose a solid color just so it's a little bit more clear. Choose color, solid color here. You can see that is still there. If I change the opacity, what happens is that the shadow disappears completely. So because he was asking this specific question, I did a little bit of sleuthing and I discovered that the way to do this, or the way that I would go about getting that shadow in here so that you can see the shadow, and this would be sort of like a good tip for if you're doing any sort of like diorama. I've seen that's been sort of a popular thing that's going around, is you can actually apply a transparent PNG to this location. So what I'm going to do here is go to select. And so what I did is I just opened up Photoshop and I made a 1x1 pixel location, and then I turned off the background and then exported as a PNG. So if I do this texture, there's this little tiny transparent thing. Material, I'll just change this to transparent. And I use this. Hold on. It's hard for me to tell. Is that the one? Yeah. Okay, so we have to make sure the opacity is up. So that is still transparent, but now you can see that shadow. And if for whatever reason you don't want to see these edges, which is very possible, you just want this to look like it's not there, you just select them, right click, and go hide. And now you have an invisible plane in there that's casting a shadow. So I thought this would be a really cool way to show you guys how to make shadows in your sectional dioramas. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.